you get nice and soft. And then you can just take it from the base with some soft rolls. Oh,
yeah.
And just start slowly cranking it down. Just straighten out and then let it cool.
Hang fire.
I didn't even get a chance to yell.
All right, well, we're, this is a period correct camp, so nobody say anything. Just remember, the lights are period correct. The cars are period correct. So we only had about two days, a little more than 2 days to hunt, to try to videotape a period hunt during the flintlock season. The weather was good for what it was. It's not ideal. Sloshy, snowy, rainy, wet day. That's not good for flintlock hunting, but we did see a lot of deer and just weren't able to get one in that time frame. The deer were doing magic tricks on us, I swear. I mean, it was crazy. We would do little silent man drives towards one another, and what would happen was is we'd turn around and look right after we left, and we'd come back through and there's deer standing right where we just left. It's just the way it goes with deer hunting. Kind of tough wearing the period dress and in the cold weather. You can't be sitting there all day in one spot, so we're sort of moving around, and it's been tough hunting. We had some very close opportunities, but that's really hard to videotape that reenactment style that I normally do with the videos in a 2 day period. So that's where I usually take the entire season to make one period flintlock video. And that just goes to show you how much time is being put into these videos. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Joe and Frank come back from the early season to try to get some more doe. They still had the tags. And then at the very end, I walked down through the pines to drive some deer towards them. I turned around and looked back where I just came from. That big, big buck that I videotaped, I just walked from there, and so they came from behind me. I turned around. If I would have never turned around, they would have snuck behind me. I would have never saw them. So just a little glimpse into how the hunting has been. The deer have just been running circles around us all day. And just seeing little glimpses of them, or they're just right out there too far, or they're just not stopping and just going too fast.
Not
so
cooperating. Well, yeah. I had a great time with John for the opportunity.
Yeah, I'm glad you guys had fun.
It's been a blast.
These guys came clear from Lancaster, and so
with the long rifle.
Yeah, but it's fun. We saw some deer and turkeys and that's wildlife, nice. And take a nice walk in the woods. So, all right, guys. So I'm editing the video here. And I got some footage that just doesn't have a really good place for it. So I wanted to show you a little bit behind the scenes of this video, what happened, some of the deer that we saw that just didn't fit in the reenactment part of it. I was up in these pines, I saw a doe, and it was sneaking towards me, and then it turned around and it almost acted like it was getting chased by a buck. And I waited there for like 10, 15 minutes, nothing. So I saw Joe at the bottom of the pines. So I walk down to talk to him. As we're talking, he looks up right where I just came from, and he says, "Hey, that looks like a deer." So here's the footage of us looking up at that deer.
Barking big, thought, he looks like an elk in the stock that he recognized right away. He's checking us out.
It's a buck.
It's a buck? Yep.
Goofy looking buck.
Well, I have more stories to tell you.
Just hold on here.
It's just enough of like different to not look like a tree.
Yeah.
It's pretty still, isn't it?
Yeah. Huh. I can't. Is the goofiest looking deer I've ever seen. It's so weird because I literally was standing right where that buck was for 15 minutes, just, I don't know, 2-3 minutes before I ran the camera, zoomed the camera up there and saw him. So there's that footage there. Then, you know, I was sneaking up looking at doe where the big down deadfalls were. And I snuck up on 4 or 5 deer, and you could see that there were two young ones, and they separated from themselves. I watched the one bed down, and I could have shot that one. There was a rock in front of it, and I didn't feel safe with a shot, and it was pretty far through the woods. The camera's zooming in quite a long ways, and the other one was facing right at me. I didn't like the shot, so I just passed up on those shots. Again, in a reenactment long hunter, those guys would probably be taking those shots at the deer, but you know, that it's more or less, I was really hoping to take a bigger doe because we had a lot of big doe, and those things are just eluding me. they're harder to find and see than the big bucks, it seems sometimes. But just wanted to show you, there's a couple of little clips to show you how far through the woods some of these things are, and some of the things that we see don't really, it's hard to explain with a reenactment video. In the same way with that big buck, you know, they were way up in the pines. I had no idea that there was a buck there. There was actually three. I never got the camera on the third one, and it looked really big too. But I zoomed in, and I'm looking, and I'm like, okay, I can't tell. And it's kind of like, well, why didn't you take a shot at that buck? Well, number one, from where I'm standing, you could hardly even see the antlers. It looked kind of like antlers, but look at all the branches. It was really hard to tell. And then you would have been really pressed, hard pressed to count the points. So my camera is my binoculars. And so it's on a tripod and I'm trying to get it set down, do that with one hand while holding the gun because I don't have a, you know, sling on my long rifle. So I'm zooming in and you would have had a been hard time just to count the points on that buck. So even the angle of the deer, trying to count the points, nothing was safe about that shot. I mean, yeah, I could have shot at that deer, but it wouldn't have been an ethical shot to take from my perspective. I mean, the camera is not my eyes, right? So my eyes couldn't have seen what the camera sees. So I'm using the camera just to zoom in, see what things are, and just went ahead of time. So I tried sneaking up on that buck a couple different places, trying to catch him coming to the next rows, but they obviously took off running and bumped them out, and we never did try to go back after them because it was just, at that point in time, they knew that we were on them. So just a little bit of behind the scenes stuff of what it's like trying to videotape a reenactment hunt and all the intricacies that it takes to try to make it flush and smooth throughout that. And there's a lot of footage that we just never use. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Please share it, tell others about it, like the video, comment. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Till next year.